Oh, here we are again. Hey, I got track pants on this time. Look, socks, chat. Okay. All right. Everybody said that I didn't have socks on the last time. They were just tan. Everybody thought I was showing toes. Hey, so it appears we're back for, I guess, Couch Chat 2.0 or something. Hi, my name's One Peg. I'm a content creator on Twitch and on YouTube. I've been a content creator full-time now for 3 years. I've been making content about Escape from Tarkov primarily, but a bunch of other games and a lot of other things for going on a little over 5 years now. In fact, my 2-year partner anniversary on Twitch is in about 2 weeks. I've made a name for myself in this space as someone that I believe has been incredibly fair when it comes to critiques I make about games like Escape from Tarkov, as well as the things that I believe the developers do well. What's really funny is 3 days ago I was sitting on this couch saying, depending on where somebody came in to my content and what it was that they consumed, they would consider me either to be someone that was extremely critical of the developers or a developer grinder. I say this because it was brought to my attention this morning in a DM that I got from another content creator that apparently someone, this guy that goes by the name of Goat, looks kind of like an ass, doesn't he? Said that I was a BSG or a game developer simp. And I can't help but laugh because the sentiment of me being a simp above everyone else that has made a name for themselves in the content creation space is like, dear journal, I heard a really, really great joke today. I'm going to assume that this person, who seems like they have a few subscribers at this point, and I can understand the grind, probably doesn't understand the history that I have with Tarkov and the history that I have with BSG and my working relationship with them. So I figured I would take a second and show you something real quick. You see this t-shirt? See this t-shirt? It says Russians cheat across the chest. Up here, you'll notice there's this little red number. That is a denotation of ping. The reason why this shirt exists is because back in the day, when Tarkov was new, when Labs was free, going back maybe 4 years now, 3.5 years, four years, I made a video that is now hidden. The reason for this video was to show that back when Tarkov didn't have any ping restrictions, people were utilizing that high ping to their advantage by playing aggressively, coined ping abuse. That phrase, for Peeker's advantage in Tarkov, ping abuse, exists because that video got 300,000 views in an extremely short amount of time and caused a massive amount of problems in the Tarkov community. Prior to that, when Eroctic got copyright struck, I quit my job extremely publicly as an emissary for Tarkov by saying that I did not think that BSG was capable of handling PR. To this day, I have still said that. 3 days ago, I made a video sitting on this couch talking about how they are inept in their ability to do adequate PR, and we desperately needed publicly facing tweets, especially as it pertained to third-party pieces of software like the LUT program that was developed by Art is War a handful of days ago, so that we as a community knew what was and wasn't allowed when it came to widespread software use. And lo and behold, there was a public tweet about a piece of software for the first time in 2.5 years. 2.5 years! Now, I'm not trying to take credit for trying to spur them into action, but it's kind of coincidental, don't you think? And I'm not going to sit here and try to defend every little piece of content that I've made. The fact of the matter is, I have, as far as I have tried to be, Switzerland. I haven't overly praised the development team for the things that they do. I have attempted to be understanding for the development process, which is something that I feel as though you, as the content creator in this case, I guess I'm talking to Goat now, I feel as though perhaps you don't understand. But I would challenge you that if your content derivations are going to be created from, I guess, trying to call out other content creators, you might want to consider doing that a little bit differently. Because when I did it for the Eastern European guys that were phoning it in to US East and the Central US to try and gain an advantage so that they could hop up on the leaderboards back when Tarkov still had leaderboard level contests, that didn't go well for them. That didn't go well for me because it looked like I was speaking as to the intention of other content creators, and I lost friends, people that I hadn't intended on actually harming got harmed. Thankfully, over the years, I have been able to repair those relationships. But you know what I haven't been able to repair? My relationship with Battle State's development team. Because to this day, there are people on that dev team that think that I am a piece of walking shit. And I probably will never change that. So to say that I am simping for the company is one of the most ridiculous things I think could have come out of the mouth of anyone making a YouTube video about me ever. That is wild. Like, oh man, I guess I should feel flattered. Like, you actually thought that I was important enough to make a video about, although I guess I'm doing the same thing here. I guess I'm using this as more of a PSA, but you thought that I was important enough to make a video about, or that I was prominent enough in the community to bother making mention of. And the fact that I think that I am a nobody in this community, for the most part, that's good. That's good. To the content creators out there that think that calling out other people is a good idea, don't do that. All it makes it look like is you're having an incredibly slow news day. Oh, okay. Hi. So you want to come sit with me? I got interrupted by my daughter. See, because I have 3 kids. So if making content about me drives more people to me, or me making a clickbait title like the one that you referenced in your video, saying where I was talking about major changes. It's called clickbait, by the way. If me doing that generates more views, which generates more ad revenue, so that I can make sure that she has a good life, quite honestly, I don't care, bro. You can make all the stuff you want about me. Call me all the names you want. At the end of the day, I'm going to keep being me. I'm going to keep generating the content that I've been generating. And I'm going to do it with a smile on my face. And if you, in 3 months, don't get the replay system that you say that you need in order to be able to continue making content about Tarkov, if you don't get that and you quit, I'm sure that there will be an abundance of very low effort, nothing was lost that day memes that get generated as a result. Because there's probably 2 million unique accounts in Tarkov. 100,000 concurrent players, depending on the time of the day or the week. And honestly, man, along with me, we're all in the same boat. No one really cares. Anyway, fellas, that's what I have for this one. Thanks so much for coming to my little couch talk. We'll see you in the next one, okay? You want to say bye? Say bye.
Bye.